إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Inshallah, we have the class of tafsir from Surah Ali Imran. Surah Ali Imran. طيب بارك الله فيك. Inshallah, verse 137. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قد خلت من قبلكم سنن فصيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين. قد خلت من قبلكم سنن فصيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين. قال الإمام الشيخ عبد الرحمن رحمه الله في قول الله عز وجل: قد خلت من قبلكم سنن فسيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين، هذا بيان للناس وهدى وموعظة للمتقين. وهذه الآيات الكريمات وما بعدها في قصة أحد يعزي تعالى عباده المؤمنين ويسليهم ويخبرهم أنه مضى قبلهم أجيال وأمم كثيرة امتحنوا وابتلي المؤمنون منهم بقتال الكافرين، فلم يزالوا في مداولة ومجاولة حتى جعل الله العاقبة للمتقين والنصر لعباده المؤمنين. وآخر الأمر حصلت الدولة على المكذبين، وخذلهم الله بنصر رسله وأتباعهم. فسيروا في الأرض بأبدانكم وقلوبكم فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين، فإنكم لا تجدونهم إلا معذبين بأنواع العقوبات الدنيوية. قد خوت ديارهم وتبين لكل أحد خسارهم، وذهب عزهم وملكهم، وزال بذخهم وفخرهم. البذخ والتكبر. أفليس في هذا أعظم دليل وأكبر شاهد على صدق ما جاءت به الرسل وحكمة الله التي يمتحن بها عباده ليبلوهم ويتبين صادقهم من كاذبهم؟ ولهذا قال تعالى: هذا بيان للناس، أي دلالة ظاهرة تبين للناس الحق من الباطل وأهل السعادة من أهل الشقاوة، وهو الإشارة إلى ما أوقع الله بالمكذبين. وهدى وموعظة للمتقين، لأنهم هم المنتفعون بالآيات فتهديهم إلى سبيل الرشاد، وتعظهم وتزجرهم عن طريق الغي. وأما باقي الناس فهي بيان لهم تقوم به عليهم الحجة من الله ليهلك من هلك عن بينة. ويحتمل أن الإشارة في قوله هذا بيان للناس للقرآن العظيم والذكر الحكيم، وأنه بيان للناس عموما وهدى وموعظة للمتقين خصوصا، وكلا المعنيين حق. In this ayah, verse 137, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ سُنَنْ. Many similar ways have passed away before you. Many similar ways were faced by nations that have passed away before you. فصيروا في الأرض. So travel through the earth. Travel through the earth. فانظر كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين. And see what was the end of those who disbelieve. قد خلت من قبلكم سنن. What has passed before is ways. The ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deal with His creation. Especially how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deal with His enemy, those who oppose His message, His tawheed, and those who took His messengers as an enemy. What Allah did to them. Fasiru fil ard. So travel through the earth. فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين. And see what was the end of those who disbelieve. So many ayat in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah call the people to go and travel through the earth with the intention to see what happened to the enemy of Allah Azza wa Jal. What was the end of those who disbelieve the messengers of Allah? If you do so, you will find that there was no nation which opposed the messengers of Allah, save it ended with a bad ending. And many of their homes and lands can be seen until today. Until today, especially those Arabs who were present at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they used to see morning and evening. As Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Safat, وَبِاللَّيْلِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. So they have two caravans, the summer time and the winter time, from Mecca to Yemen and to Sham. They used to pass by many nations' lands before them who were destroyed by Allah Azza wa Jal, especially in Yemen area, like the people of Shu'aib. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them to travel through the earth in their mind, contemplation, and physically. So they see the ending and the evil ending of those who oppose the Messenger of Allah. That itself is a proof and evidence that the Messenger of Allah called people to truth. See what happened to the enemy of Prophet Musa and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them in the ocean. What happened to the people of Lut and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal punished them. Their cities are underground until now. Still people are looking for. The people of Ad, the people of those whom Messenger Hud were sent to, those Messenger Salih were sent to, those Messenger Nuh were sent to, and so many nations. Only Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not informed all the nations. وَرُسُلًا قَدْ قَصَصْنَا عَلَيْكَ وَرُسُلًا لَمْ نَقْصُصُمْ عَلَيْكَ. Some messengers' stories was not even related to the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what has been mentioned by Allah Azza wa Jal is enough. So in many ayat Allah command that people look into the history and look to the history and the stories of the previous nations. أسأل الله سنة نذر آية أفلم يسيروا في الأرض فينظروا كيف كان عاقبة الذين من قبلهم نذر آية أولم يسيروا في الأرض فينظروا كيف كان عاقبة الذين كانوا من قبلهم النذر آية قل سيروا في الأرض ثم انظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين النذر آية قل سيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين This آية قد خلت من قبلكم سنن فصيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين In Surah Al-Mulk What was the ayah in Surah Al-Mulk? نعم Yes وكل من رزق وإليه النشور ولقد كذب الذين من قبلهم فكيف كان نكير ولقد كذب الذين من قبلهم Indeed, those before them belie They disbelieve فكيف كان نكير أي نكيري How was my punishment? It is known So by knowing the history and that whoever opposed the messengers of Allah were ended they end up destruction and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them severely regardless how the messengers of Allah and their followers were small number were weak materially but that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave his messengers the victory then you will know that what they call people to Ishaq was the truth and the same thing happened even to those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was addressing in this ayat those when Allah revealed those verses Allah Azza wa Jal subhanahu wa ta'ala was addressing those people who lived that time as he subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses every people. So for instance the Quraysh, they were listening to the Quran. It is them whom Allah commanded them to go and travel through the earth. So they get lesson, they get They benefit from that. But they rejected. What happened to them? Now we know that what happened to them. Where is Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, those who kick out the messenger Muhammad from Mecca, his companion from Mecca, used to torture people, the believers. Where are they now? Where do they live? Where do they live? Where Abu Jahl? The remaining, those who on his way, on his path, where are they? Everyone is running from Abu Jahl today, wherever he may be. No one has something to do with Abu Jahl and his group. But on the other hand, as for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how many people are honor. How many people are following Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam all over the world, different nations, all over the world. Go to the Russia, go to the India, go to Australia, go to America, go out to Africa, go to Europe, everywhere. You hear أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله let alone مكة and مدينة how many ayat Allah mentioned that the good ending will be for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ورفعنا لك ذكرك إن شانئك هو الأبتر when one of the idol worshippers said bad about the Prophet Muhammad sallam and he said that he is going to die soon and he has no one behind him so he said to his people be patient don't worry about He means the Prophet ﷺ. He's going to die and he doesn't have anyone behind him. He will be cut off. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered back to that one. Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. Indeed, the one who hates you, he's the one who's cut off. Not you. So, by knowing the history and the good ending of those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and accepted the tawheed, and on the other hand, the evil ending of those who disbelieve Allah azza wa jal, whoever they may be, wherever they may live, then you will know that what the messengers of Allah call people to is the truth. And whoever opposed them were the losers. So in this ayah Allah said, قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ سُنَنْ فَصِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Many similar ways have passed away, so go through, travel through the earth to see and see what was the end of those who disbelieve. What was the end of those who disbelieve? فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين. Then Allah said, هذا بيان للناس. This, the Quran, is a plain statement for mankind. Is a clarification, is a proof for all mankind, evidence for all mankind. Anyone who knows the Quran, what Quran calls to. The people who truly follow the Quran, what they are upon. Those who oppose the Quran, what they are upon. The knowledge which is in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, anyone who knows, that will be for him a proof, bayan, plain statement, evidence and clear. But as for the believers, wahudan wa maw'idah, guidance and instruction to the al-muttaqoon. So the Quran is proof for everyone, is evidence. And it is for guidance and admonition only for the muttaqeen, only for the believers. هذا بيان للناس. This is a plain statement for mankind. This is general. Anyone who knows the Quran, anyone who knows the reality of the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, must for sure know that this is the book of Allah Azza wa Jal and that it is haq and truth. Whether he believes or he disbelieves, he must know it, because truth is truth. But acceptance and submission to it is another thing. It is to the person. But the truth is truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هذا بيان للناس وهودا, and it is a guidance وموعظة, an admonition, instruction للمتقين, for those who have taqwa. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. This is the book, that is the book, there is no doubt in it, is guidance for muttaqin, for the pious. So the one who doesn't follow Quran is not going to be guidance for him. Quran is not guidance for everyone. It's not. It's only guidance for those who follow it. Those who adhere to it, those who follow the instructions of the Quran, it is those whom Quran is going to be a guidance for them. Jazakallahu khair. But as for evidence, it's for everyone. Everyone who knows the Quran must know that it is haq and truth. Allahu Akbar. The book of Allah Azza wa Jal calls people to that which is good. Only that which is good. And forbids that which is evil. You will never find anything good in this happening today, anything good done by any human being, regardless of his background, anything truly good, you'll find it's enjoined in the Quran. Anything evil, you find is forbidden in the Quran. And you look for. Some people, they're so amazed when they say they see that the system, that some nation, some countries or some companies, they have to properly handle their tasks. They're very surprised, even though those may not be Muslims. But if you find in the deen of Allah, you find so many texts calling the believer to be mada, to do the job to the best of his ability. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْعَبْدَ يَعْمَلُ الْعَمَلَ فَيُتْقِنُ. Allah loves the servant when he does the job, he perfects it. Allah loves it. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything. Prophet ﷺ says to the people, seek medicine. Tadawu, seek medicine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هو الذي جعلكم أرضا لونا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه. Travel to the earth and eat from his provision. سخر لكم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. Everything in the heaven and the earth was subjected for you. Everything. If it's subjected for you, then you need to benefit from it. Everything, not only on the earth. ما في السماوات. المهم. So in this ayah, that the Quran is plain statement and a proof for all mankind, and it is a guidance and admonition for the muttaqun, for those who have taqwa. So the more you obey the teachings of the Quran, the instructions in the Quran, the instructions in the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you make it into application, it doesn't remain just a knowledge and theory, yeah, knowledge, education, rather it's applied. Then the more you do so, the more you get the guidance. Therefore, you find so many Muslims who know much of the deen, maybe even memorizing Quran, know the Arabic, know, maybe graduate from universities. If you see them out there, it's like they know nothing. It's like they know nothing. If they make ibadah and they do an act of worship, it is full of innovations. Full of innovations. If not, then full of sin and crime. In a way, you say, this person, did he ever come to know anything about Islam? Did this woman ever hear about Islam? How she look like this way? How she walk this way? Why is this Muslim, who even born in a Muslim land, why is he? What happened? One time, I was where there is a Muslim restaurant. There was Muslims who were there. Seven youth, Allahu A'lam, between 20 and 35. Seven. Five of them were drinking with the left hand. And those they grow in a Muslim land. Why? What happened to them? Seven. Five out of seven Muslims drinking, eating with the left hand. What happened to them? Because no doubt that they know it. No doubt. I have no doubt any Muslim who grow in a Muslim land, he knows that eating with the left hand is not allowed. Rather, in some countries, they even consider the one who does that kafir. They have so extreme. The one they see eating and drinking with the left, they even don't consider a Muslim. Because those who do that are the non-Muslims who are there. But yet, this is how those Muslims are acting. It's like they do not know anything, and they know it. So for them, Quran in this issue is not guidance for them. The Sunnah is not guidance for them. Naam, unlike the other one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide him to the love of the deen. Whatever he hears, whatever he comes to know from the deen of Allah, he applies for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You find within a few days or months or year, you think when you see him as a scholar. How he applied the deen of Allah, how much he knows. And the reason is this one he applies. And when you act upon knowledge, it remains. If you don't act upon it, you forget it. It's one of the virtue of the knowledge over wealthy money. That as for the knowledge, if you apply it, if you teach it, it increases. Unlike the wealth, unless you spend it to the cause of Allah, it also increases. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمْ الْعَلَوْنِ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Who going to remind us another ayah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that Allah command to travel through the earth to see what happened to the previous nations who disbelieve the messengers of Allah. Naam. Barakallahu fiqh. Surah Al-Fil. Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi ashabi al-fil. Even this is very famous, known incident among the Arabs. And that happened the year the Prophet ﷺ born. It is called the year of the elephant. When a man, a Christian man, with an elephant, with the soldiers, among the soldiers' elephants, he trained them, tried to attack the Kaaba to destroy it. What happened? They know it. They call Amul Fil the year of the elephant. Alam tara kayfa fa'ala rabbuka bi ashabil fil. Didn't you see what your Lord did to the people of the elephant? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them with birds. The Arabs, they know that. And not only that, it is them who said that this man will have bad ending if he tries to attack the house of Allah. So say, they say, let we go out of Makkah. Because Allah will punish this man who is going to try to humiliate his house. They believe that. So they paved the way. They left Makkah. They were on the mountains. Safa wal Marwa, which were back days used to be mountains. Looking what will happen to the man who wants to attack the Kaaba. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent birds carrying stones, stoning them. Allah destroyed all of them. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's one. The reason is, remember the power of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he wants subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy his enemy. If he wants to use birds, how can you attack yourself? How can you defend yourself against a bird which flies? Subhanallah. When you go to the Kaaba, you see those birds, you remember. Yes, always in the Kaaba there are birds flying on the Kaaba. Allahu A'lam. Is he making tawaf? Allahu A'lam. Allahu A'lam. Always you see birds in the Kaaba. You remember that the birds are from the soldiers of Allah Azza wa Jal. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَمَا هِيَ إِلَّا ذِكْرَ لِلْبَشَرِ. Another ayah. بارك الله في هل أتاك حديث الجنود. يعني did you receive the history of the soldiers of the arm? Who are they? فرعون وثمود. فرعون and ثمود. بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب. Nay, those who disbelieve, they are in disbelief. They know this, but they deny it. نعم, another ayah. نعم. هل أتاك حديث موسى إذ ناداه ربه. That ayah. نعم. Prophet Musa عليه السلام. المهم نعم كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح وعاد كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح وعاد وفرعون ذو الأوتاد وثمود وقوم لوط وأصحاب الأيكة أولئك الأحزاب إن كل إلا كذب الرسل فحق عقاب. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned and those people, what they used to do, today there are people who are doing it. Everything previous nations used to do to oppose the messengers, today you have people who are doing it. Mainly those people used to do shirk. They used to worship other than Allah. They were in common in this. All of them used to worship other than Allah. Therefore, every messenger says, ما لكم من إله أعبد الله ما لكم من إله غيره. Whether they believe the existence of Allah and that was the most of the people, or they deny the existence of Allah, messengers used to call them first to Allah Azza wa Jal. Believe in Allah your Lord, worship Him alone. So they used to reject that. With that they had other major sin. Some of them cheating and deceiving in measurement. Like the people of who? People of who? Those who used to deny, those who used to reduce the measurement. They were very famous. The people of Prophet Shu'aib. أوفوا الكيلة ولا تكونوا من المخسرين. They were very famous. Is that something existing today? So much. What happened in some Muslim land? لا إله إلا الله. You don't get a pure honey. They put sugar in it. You don't get a pure milk. They put water in it. So many things. So many things. They reduce the scale. In a way, it's very hard to find something, the origin. So whoever does that is following the enemy of Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam. Also, other nations, what they used to do, like the people of Lut, Prophet Lut alayhi salam, his people, A'udhu Billah, today they are very widespread. A'udhu Billah. Today they strongly increasing, spreading their evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroy. They are out there. Subhanallah. 1,400 years ago, Allah mentioned people used to do that. Still, there are people who are doing it, calling people to it. A'udhu Billah. Also, the people of Ad, what they used to do, build strong buildings inside the mountains, and they used to punish people. They used to be very tyrant. وَإِذَا بَطَشْتُمْ بَطَشْتُمْ جَبَّارِينَ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ. Fear Allah. So there are people who are tyrants and oppressors. نعم. So all those deviations are what those previous nations did of sin is still being done by so many people. طيب Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمْ لَعْلَوْنَا إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. So do not become weak against your enemy nor be sad. وَأَنْتُمْ لَعْلَوْنَ and you will be superior. إن كنتم مؤمنين if you are indeed true believers. شيخ سعد السائر رحمه الله تعالى this ayah and those after it are about the battle of Uhud. The battle of Uhud, it is known. What year was it? What was the battle of Uhud took place? The third year. The third year Yes, the third year of the Hijrah. So that battle, which many of the Sahaba were killed, so many of the companions of the Messenger were killed in that battle by the idol worshippers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَهِنُوا, don't become weak. Means all believers, because of what you go through. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا, nor be sad, don't grieve. وَأَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ, you are the superior. You will be superior. إِنْ كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ, if you are indeed true believers. If you are true believers, you shouldn't grieve, you shouldn't be sad, because you will be superior over your enemy. إِنْ يَمْسَسْكُمْ قَرْحٌ فَقَدْ مَسَّ الْقَوْمَ قَرْحٌ. If a wound or killing has touched you, O believers, فَقَدْ مَسَّ الْقَوْمَ قَرْحٌ مِثْلُ. Be assured, a similar wound or killing has touched the others, meaning the disbelievers. A similar wound or similar killing has touched them. That is the ulama, they say, is what happened to the kuffar in the battle of Badr. The battle of Badr, 70 of the idol worshippers were killed. And 70 were taken as captives. The battle of Badr. In the battle of Uhud, 70 of the Sahaba, Ridwanullah ta'ala alayhim, were killed. So in this ayah, Allah said, إِن يَمْسَسْكُمْ قَرْحٌ فَقَدْ مَسَّ الْقَوْمَ قَرْحٌ مِثْلُ. If a wound or killing has touched you, be assured a similar wound or killing has touched them. وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوُلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. And such are the days, good and not so good, that we give to man by turns. That we give to man by turns. نُدَاوُلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. Some days is easy for you. You get the victory over your enemy. Some days is the opposite. That we give to man by turns. وَلِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شِهَدَاءَ. And that Allah may test those who believe, and that He may take a shuhada from among you. That He may take subhanahu wa ta'ala martyrs from among you. Wallahu la yuhibbu dhalimin. Allah likes not the dhalimin. So if you see the dhalimin, the disbelievers, have a victory, it is not because Allah loved them. No, Allah doesn't love the zalimin, whether they get victory or they don't get. And Allah loves the believers, whereas they lose or they get victory. Because being victorious is not connected to the righteousness. There are so many prophets who were killed by their enemy. وَيَقْتُلُونَ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ. They used to kill the prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal. So whether the disbeliever get victory over the believers, or as it happened the day of Uhud, or they lose and the believers get the victory like the day of Badr, in both cases Allah la yuhibbu al-zalimin. Allah doesn't like the zalimin. And on the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes al-mu'minin, al-sabirin, the believers. So don't ever think because you get victory over your enemy, it necessarily means that Allah loves you. Or you lose in the battlefield, it necessarily means that Allah hates you. No. If you are a believer, you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you obey Him azza wa jal, Allah loves you. Whether you are healthy or you are sick, whether you're rich or you're poor, whether you get victory or you are defeated. Allah loves you subhanahu wa ta'ala because of iman wal amal salih. Because of al-iman wal amal salih. That is the way to know if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you or not. If Allah guide you to His religion, you obey Him, you love Him, you remember Him, you remain patient in the difficult, thankful, you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ease, in all your situations, you love your Lord, you remember Him, you obey Him, you rely on Him, you fear of Him, then know that Allah guide you subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah guide you. Do not know that Allah likes you or not through having worldly life or losing worldly life. So Allah mentioned in His book that's the way some people they think. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانِ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَّرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا. So that's the way some people think. If Allah makes their life easy, worldly life easy, they say, Rabbi Akraman, my Lord, honor me. My Lord, honor me. He knows I deserve. That's why He honored me. He make my life easy. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests them with difficult, they say, Rabbi Ahanan, my Lord, humiliate me. Allah says, Kalla, nay. That's not the way it is. It's not that way. So Allah in this ayah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though He mentioned that the believers killing and wounding touch the believers, but yet Allah la yuhibbu dhalimin. Allah doesn't like subhanahu wa ta'ala the dhalimin, the polytheists, the wrongdoers. Then what is the hikmah, the wisdom behind the enemy of Allah being victorious sometimes? Allah mentions subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَاءَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may take from you shuhada, martyrs, those who die in the cause of Allah, and they get the high level. They get the high level in the Jannah. Also, وَلِيُمَحِّصَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَمْحَقَّ الْكَافِرِينَ. That Allah may test or purify the believers from sins and destroy the disbelievers. That Allah may test or purify the believers. وَيَمْحَقَ الْكَافِرِينَ and destroy the disbelievers. So this is from the hikmah, wisdom, some of the wisdom, why the believers, even though they were the sahaba of the Messenger Sallam, those whom Allah loved them, why they went through difficulty in the battle of Uhud, why believers go through difficult sometimes, their enemy get the victory over them. Hikmah is Allah to have among them shuhada, those who reach that high level. And also, in order Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to distinguish between the good and the bad, to test them who remain patient in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ease and in the difficult, and who turn away in the difficult. وَلِيُمَحِّصَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَمْحَقَ الْكَافِرِينَ أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ وَلَمَّا يَعْلَمِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا مِنْكُمْ وَيَعْلَمَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Do you think that you will enter paradise before Allah tests those of you who fought in the cause, in His cause, and also tests those who are as-sabirin, the patient? Do you think you will enter Jannah without Allah testing you? Or do you think that you will enter paradise before Allah tests those of you who fought in the cause of Allah, and also Allah tests those who are as-sabirun? Means that's not going to happen. It's not the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. That whoever says he is a believer, he enters right away the Jannah. Rather, there are tests. Sometimes tests with the enemy, sometimes with the health, with the wealth, sometimes with other difficulties and hardships. All this test from Allah. وَلَقَدْ كُنْتُمْ تَمَنَّوْنَ الْمَوْتَ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ تَلْقَوْهُ فَقَدْ رَأَيْتُمُوهُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. And you had indeed long for death, the Sahaba, before you met it. Now you have seen it openly with your own eyes. وَلَقَدْ كُنْتُمْ تَمَنَّوْنَ الْمَوْتَ. And you indeed, you had long for death, longer for death. You were seeking for death. You were seeking the fight against the enemy to be legislated. فَقَدْ رَأَيْتُمُوهُ. You have seen it. وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. While you're looking at it, you have seen it openly with your own eyes. It is known in the history that the Prophet ﷺ, when he consulted with his Sahaba in the battle of Uhud, and he ﷺ saw the battle of Uhud in dream, and he relayed it to his Sahaba, and then the enemy came around Medina. Prophet ﷺ, he gathered his Sahaba, he consulted with them what to do. Do they go outside Medina, the believers, before the enemy reach Medina, and they fight them in there outside Medina, or they wait until the enemy enters the city and there they fight? And most of the Sahaba had the opinion not to wait them, rather to go. They say, oh, the Messenger of Allah, they were not used to allow the Ansar, even the Jahiliyyah time, someone to fight them in Medina. How they allowing that to happen in Islam? So many Sahaba, Ridwanullah Ta'ala alayhim, had the opinion to go outside Medina and to confront the enemy in outside, not in the city. And from the reasons, they said that it's not good to fight in the middle of the children, in the middle of the elders, in the middle of the women and the like. So only soldiers to be those who fight. But the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and some other companion and some munafiqun had the opinion to fight inside the Medina. Inside the Medina, because that will help the Muslims to not to feel the less number. Because the far you go, an open land, miles, thousands of miles, for instance, the much number, the much soldiers you needed. Unlike a small spot, place, few number can defend it. But the Sahaba, Ridwanullah Ta'ala alayhim, who were going to fight the enemy, were more. And they were very strong in their opinion. They are the Messenger of Allah, we go, we don't wait them. They really love so much to confront the enemy. And Allah mentioned another ayat, even before Allah legislated the jihad, some of the believers, they used to ask for fight, or Allah to legislate the jihad fi sabilillah. They used to ask. So Allah mentioned in his Quran, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ قِيلَ لَهُمْ كُفُّوا أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ. So Allah said in this ayah, وَلَقَدْ كُنْتُمْ تَمَنَّوْنَ الْمَوْتِ. Then the Prophet ﷺ, he took the opinion of the majority of the Sahaba, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went out of the Medina, and it is known where the battle of Uhud took place, it outside the city. So Allah said, وَلَقَدْ كُنْتُمْ تَمَنَّوْنَ الْمَوْتَ. And you had indeed تَمَنَّوْنَ الْمَوْتَ. You were wishing the death, to die in the cause of Allah. مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن تَلْقَوْهُ. Before you met it. فَقَدْ رَأَيْتُمُوهُ. You have seen it. وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ with your own eyes. قال الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعد رحمه الله في قول الله عز وجل, إن يمسسكم قرح فقد مس القوم قرح ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا وأنتم الأعلون إن كنتم مؤمنين. يقول تعالى مشجعا لعباده المؤمنين ومقويا لعزائمهم ومنهضا لهممهم، ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا، أي ولا تهنوا وتضعفوا في أبدانكم ولا تحزنوا في قلوبكم عندما أصابتكم المصيبة وابتليتم بهذه البلوى، فإن الحزن في القلوب والوهن على الأبدان زيادة مصيبة عليكم وعون لعدوكم عليكم، بل شجعوا قلوبكم وصبروها وادفعوا عنها الحزن وتصلبوا على قتال عدوكم. وذكر تعالى أنه لا ينبغي ولا يليق بهم الوهن والحزن وهم الأعلون في الإيمان ورجاء نصر الله وثوابه. فالمؤمن المتيقن ما وعده الله من الثواب الدنيوي والأخروي لا ينبغي منه ذلك، ولهذا قال تعالى وأنتم الأعلون إن كنتم مؤمنين. قال الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله ولا تهنوا ولا تحزنوا، أي لا تهنوا وتضعفوا في أبدانكم ولا تحزنوا في قلوبكم عندما أصابتكم المصيبة وابتليتم بهذه البلوى، فإن الحزن في القلوب والوهن على الأبدان زيادة مصيبة عليكم وعون لعدوكم عليكم، بل شجعوا قلوبكم وصبروها وادفعوا عنها الحزن وتصلبوا على قتال عدوكم. وذكر تعالى أنه لا ينبغي ولا يليق بهم الوهن والحزن وهم الأعلون في الإيمان ورجاء نصر الله وثوابه. فالمؤمن المتيقن ما وعده الله من الثواب الدنيوي والأخروي لا ينبغي منه ذلك، ولهذا قال تعالى وأنتم الأعلون إن كنتم مؤمنين. ثم سلاهم بما حصل لهم من الهزيمة وبين الحكم العظيمة المترتبة على ذلك، فقال إن يمسسكم قرح فقد مس القوم قرح مثله، فأنتم وإياهم قد تساويتم في القرح، ولكنكم ترجون من الله ما لا يرجون، كما قال تعالى إن تكونوا تألمون فإنهم يألمون كما تألمون وترجون من الله ما لا يرجون. ومن الحكم في ذلك أن هذه الدار يعطي الله منها المؤمن والكافر والبر والفاجر، فيداول الله الأيام بين الناس، يوم لهذه الطائفة ويوم للطائفة الأخرى، لأن هذه الدار الدنيا منقضية فانية، وهذا بخلاف الدار الآخرة فإنها خالصة للذين آمنوا، وليعلم الله الذين آمنوا. هذا أيضا من الحكم أنه يبتلي الله عباده بالهزيمة والابتلاء ليتبين المؤمن من المنافق، لأنه لو استمر النصر للمؤمنين في جميع الوقائع لدخل في الإسلام من لا يريده، فإذا حصل في بعض الوقائع بعض أنواع الابتلاء تبين المؤمن حقيقة الذي يرغب في الإسلام في الضراء والسراء واليسر والعسر ممن ليس كذلك، ويتخذ منكم شهداء. وهذا أيضا من بعض الحكم، لأن الشهادة عند الله من أرفع المنازل، ولا سبيل للنيلها إلا بما يحصل من وجود أسبابها. فهذا من رحمته بعباد المؤمنين أن قيض له من الأسباب ما تكرهه النفوس لينيله ما يحبون من المنازل العالية والنعيم المقيم، والله لا يحب الظالمين. الذين ظلموا أنفسهم وتقاعدوا عن القتال في سبيله، وكأن في هذا تعريضا بذم المنافقين وأنهم مبغضون لله، ولهذا ثبطهم عن القتال في سبيله، ولو أرادوا الخروج لا عدوا له عدة، ولكن كره الله بعاثهم فثبطهم وقيل اقعدوا مع القاعدين. Inshallah, we stop in this ayah. We talk about the last, sometime this week, about the evil eye. Here there is question, there are people who use what they call evil eye jewelry, or they have bracelets, they have it to protect them from the evil eye. Some of them they place in their stores or houses, for instance, an egg of one of the birds. Some of them they have a chain of in their hand or their neck, and they believe this is protection from the evil eye. What is the rule of that? Some of these things are from the magicians, and some of it, it's a shirk. The least of it is innovation. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what did he taught people to use as protection from the evil eye, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Is the adhkar al-shar'iyya. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say to his two sons, Hassan and Hussein, "U'idukuma bi kalimati Allah tammati min kulli shaytan wa hamma wa min kulli 'ayn lamma." Some people, when they have a new house, they slaughter, sacrifice animal in certain way, and they put the blood inside the house or by the door. Subhanallah. Prophet ﷺ said, "من نزل منزلا فقال أعوذ بكلمات الله تامات من شر ما خلق لم يضره شيء حتى يرتحل من منزله ذلك." Anyone who, when he resides a house, he says this dua, أعوذ بكلمات الله تامات من شر ما خلق, nothing harm him until he move from there. Very easy, يعني short dua, full of tawheed, and there is a protection in it. People, they leave it, go to the farm, slaughter house, buy so much goats, slaughter by the door or inside the house sometimes. أعوذ بالله. So al-muhim, those things people have in their necks or in their hand or their legs sometimes, they call evil eye protector, and the like, is the least of it is innovation. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companion were not used to do. Sahabi al-Jalil Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu saw his wife having something like that, and he took it and he threw it. She said, "This eye blinks when I don't use it, and whenever I use this thing, it was given to me by a Jewish woman, it stops moving." She said, "It is Shaitan who touches and moves it." Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu. His wife said, whenever she used what the Jewish woman gave to her, what happened? The eye stopped moving. Otherwise, it moves. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he threw it, and he said, "It moved because Shaitan is one who touching it." Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Sheikh al-Albani authenticated that. So, avoid these things, especially in some land in Africa, especially in some country. Almost everyone has something on his neck or is in his hand. Even the students of knowledge in Medina University, they used to have these things, believing if they take it off, jinn attack them. A'udhu billah. And some of them, as we mentioned, they carry magic. Wallahi, what they have is sihr, but they don't know it. They put in a nice metal, and then you cannot even open unless you break it down. So these things avoid. Read the adhkar as sabah wal masa. After every prayer, recite qul wallahu ahad, qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq, qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas. After every mandatory prayer, recite ayatul kursi. Night time, recite last ayah of surah al-Baqarah. Naam, yes. Last two ayah of surah al-Baqarah, every night, recite it. In the morning, Bismillah, الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء, three times. In the evening, هذه الأذكار, it's full of tawheed. It connects you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In it, there is the real and true protection from all kinds of evil. Other than that, you're wasting your time, rather you will use your religion. So, anyone who having these things in his neck or put in his house, he just asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most kind person to the people, most knowledgeable one to the people, he also was sent to call to the people to do all good and to avoid all evil in their life, in their religion. Did he taught people to have these bracelets, to have these things? The answer is no. avoiding. والله أعلم، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا.